Hi, Miss Marvy here. And today, I have my friend Peter. But Peter was a naughty boy. He tried to eat so many radishes and carrots and beans in Mr. McGregor's garden. And when he tried to find the gate to get out, he couldn't get there. So he ended up going into a watering can and having a big problem. And we're gonna find out about that a little later. But rabbit begins with the letter R. Here is my R. This is an uppercase R and a lowercase R. And there's a picture of a rabbit and he is smelling a red rose. Rosa. A rabbit is smelling a red rose. So let's take a look at some other books about rabbits. This is the one I'm going to read today. It's called The Tale of Peter Rabbit. There you can see him with a carrot in his mouth. And I have the Grumpy Bunny. And that's about a rabbit. I also have Oh John the Rabbit and the Velveteen Rabbit. I have some books back here that are about rabbits too, but I also have another set of books that are raccoons. And this is Chester, and he's a raccoon. And he, not his name Chester, but he's a raccoon, and that begins with the letter R. Here's a robin, which is also an R word. And there's another book about Chester. And another book about Chester, A Pocket Full of Kisses. And this one's Chester the Brave, and this one is Chester Raccoon. And the acorn full of memories. Another thing that begins with the letter R is race cars. And you can see here in my book, they are racing on a road. Another R word. And behind me, I have a road. There are some roadblocks which we're gonna try to remove and see which ones begin with the R sound, because R says R, R says R. Every letter makes a sound and R says R. So I'm going to put my radishes on the side because I want to eat them later in a salad with some raisins. And that will taste so good. And I'm going to put Peter back here with his family. His mommy and Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail. And we'll find out what happened to Peter in a little bit. So you can take a look at those. But let's take a look at some R words. I'm going to hold some things up for you. And we've already talked about a road. Cars can go on the road. And I have railroad tracks. What goes on a railroad track? Why, a train goes on a railroad track. I also have a rocket, which goes into space. And I have a record. Now, to many of you, a record's going to look like a CD, but some of your mommies and daddies may have record players that they might play vinyl on. This is a small record, and there are larger records as well. What do I have in my R basket? Well, I have some rope that begins with R. I have a rod that begins with R. I have a reindeer that begins with R. I have a rake that Mr. McGregor is going to use in his garden when we read this story. That begins with R. And what is this? This is a house. Well, a house doesn't begin with R, but the red roof begins with R. I have a rock. I have a rabbit. I have another rabbit, and I have a rooster. That little guy is a rooster. What's the sound a rooster makes? Cock-a-doodle-doo! I have a rolling pin. I have a radio. I have a ruler, which helps to make you draw straight lines and measure things. And I have a race car back here. This is Mickey, and he is driving a race car to the racetrack to have a race on the road. Now I have one more thing to show you here, and I'm gonna show you this way. This is a cylinder. Cylinder doesn't go rrr, but a cylinder is round. This part looks like a circle, and this part is the cylinder part. And when we put a cylinder like this, it will do another R thing. It will roll. My goodness, it rolls. That's how cars go. If you put a square set of tires on a car, it wouldn't go anywhere. A car has to roll. And hopefully, I'll be able to show you your very own race car that you can make in a little bit. And it rolls. And I used marshmallows, cardboard, straws, and toothpicks to make my own race car. So let's see if I can put my things on the side, because I don't like when it's very messy. And I'm gonna get my book out for you to look at. Remember, R says R, R says R. Every letter makes a sound, and R says R. Maybe you can make that sound with me. Let's sound like, it sounds like a car. Let's try it. R. Try it again. R. All right. This is our story for today. The Tale of Peter Rabbit, by Beatrix Potter and illustrated by Amy Rosenberg. They're beautiful pictures. There he is on the title page, eating a big rabbit. Now watch what he's wearing. It looks like I see a blue coat and some shoes. I'm not sure if it's going to look like that by the end. Once upon a time, there were four rabbits. And their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. They lived with their mother in a sandbank underneath the roof of a very big fir tree. "Now, my dear," said old Mrs. Rabbit one morning, "you may go into the fields or down the lane, but don't go into Mr. McGregor's garden." "Oh, your father had an accident there. He was put into a pie by Mrs. McGregor. Now run along and don't get into mischief. I'm going out." And there you can see her going out. They're all waving to Mommy. Then old Mrs. Rabbit took a basket and her umbrella and went through the wood to the baker's. She bought a loaf of brown bread and 5 currant buns. Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail, who were good little bunnies, went down the lane to gather blackberries. I love them. But Peter, who was very naughty, He really didn't listen. He ran straight away to Mr. McGregor's garden and squeezed under the gate. First, he ate some lettuce and some French beans, and then he ate some radishes, and then, feeling rather sick, he went to look for some parsley to make his tummy feel better. There you can see him eating it down here. He's just, oh, he doesn't feel too good. He didn't listen to Mommy. But round the end of a cucumber frame, whom should he meet but Mr. McGregor? Mr. McGregor was on his hands and knees planting out young cabbages, but he jumped up and ran after Peter, waving a rake calling, "Stop, thief, stop!" Peter was most dreadfully frightened. He rushed all over the garden, for he had forgotten the way back to the gate. He lost one of his shoes among the cabbages and the other amongst the potatoes. Uh-oh, that's not good. Look at him over here. He's caught in a net. What happened? After losing them, he ran on four legs and went faster, so that I think he might have gotten away altogether if he had not unfortunately run into a gooseberry net and got caught by the large buttons on his jacket. It was a blue jacket with brass buttons, quite new. Peter gave himself up for lost, and he shed big tears. Oh, but his sobs were overheard by some friendly sparrows who flew to him in great excitement and implored him to exert himself. They wanted him to try hard to get out of there. Mr. McGregor came up with a sieve, which he intended to pop upon the head of Peter, but Peter wriggled out just in time, leaving his jacket behind him. And he rushed into the tool shed and jumped into a can. It would have been a beautiful thing to hide in if it had not had so much water in it. Mr. McGregor was quite sure that Peter was somewhere in the tool shed, perhaps hidden underneath a flower pot. So he began to turn them over carefully, looking under each. Presently, Peter sneezed. Uh-oh, Mr. McGregor was after him in no time and tried to put his foot upon Peter, who jumped out of a window, upsetting three plants. The window was too small for Mr. McGregor, and he was tired of running after Peter, so he went back to his work. Oh, Peter's lucky. Mr. McGregor wasn't happy because Peter was eating all the things from his garden. Peter sat down to rest. He was out of breath and trembling with fright, and he had not the least idea which way to go. After a time, he began to wonder about going lippity-lippity, not very fast, and looking around. He found a door and a wall, but it was locked, and there was no room for a fat little rabbit to squeeze underneath. An old mouse was running in and out over the stone doorstep, carrying peas and beans to her family in the wood. Peter asked her the way to the gate, but she had such a large pea in her mouth that she could not answer. She only shook her head at him. Peter began to cry more. I'll never get out of here. Oh my goodness, poor Peter. He would have only listened to his mother. Then he tried to find his way straight across the garden, but he became more and more puzzled, Presently he came to a pond where Mr. McGregor filled his watering cans. A white cat was staring at some goldfish. She sat very, very still, but now and then the tip of her tail twitched as if it were alive. Peter thought it was best to go away without speaking to her. He had heard about cats from his cousin, little Benjamin Bunny. He went back towards the tool shed. Suddenly, quite close to him, he heard the noise of a hoe. Eek, screech, scratch, screech, scratch, screech. Uh-oh, who could that be? Mr. McGregor. Peter scuttered underneath the bushes, but presently, as nothing happened, he came out and climbed upon a wheelbarrow and peeped out. The first thing he saw was Mr. McGregor hoeing onions. His back was turned towards Peter, and beyond him was the gate. Peter got down very quietly off his wheelbarrow, off, and he started running as fast as he could go along a straight walk behind some black currant bushes. Mr. McGregor caught sight of him at the corner. Oh no, will Peter make it? I don't know. Let me turn the page. But Peter did not care. He slipped underneath the gate and was safe at last in the wood outside the garden. Mr. McGregor hung up the little jacket and the shoes for the scarecrow to frighten the blackbirds. Peter never stopped running or looked behind him till he got home to the big fir tree. He was so tired that he flopped down upon the nice soft sand on the floor of the rabbit hole and shut his eyes. His mother was busy cooking. She wondered what he had done with his clothes. It was the second little jacket and pair of shoes that Peter had lost in a fortnight. Oh my goodness. I'm sorry to say that Peter was not very well during the evening. His mother put him to bed and made some chamomile tea, and she gave a dose of it to Peter. 1 tablespoon to be taken at bedtime. But Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail had bread and milk and blackberries for supper. That sounds yummy. Not Peter. And he stayed in bed until he got better. If he would have only listened to his mommy. And you know, this weekend is Mother's Day, so hopefully you'll do something nice with your mommy and not go against what she's telling you to do so that you can be safe. She wanted to make sure she took care of Peter. Mommies do that. They always watch out for us. So that's our story of Peter Rabbit. Now, back here, as I had said, I have a rope and some race cars. Let's see if we can check this out. Back there you can see Peter's family, Mommy, and the 3 rabbits. And let's see if I can show you the road. Okay, I'm going to see what the problem is with all these roadblocks. You may have seen some when you go out with your mommies and daddies. I'm gonna check out one of the roadblocks and see if I can remove it. What's behind there? If it's an R word, we're gonna put our thumb up. So it has to go. This is a picture of a rabbit. Does a rabbit go? Yes, it does. So I can remove that roadblock and drive the car. Here's another one. This roadblock has a racer. Does a racer go? Yes, it does. So I can remove the roadblock. Here's another car trying to get to the gas station. Will he be able to? I have a race car. Does a race car go? Yes, it does. It is an R word. So I'm gonna put my thumb up. And I can drive the car to the garage. Here's another one. Ooh, this one says danger. What's behind it? There's a rooster. Does a rooster go rrr? Why, yes it does. Let's make the rooster sound. Cock-a-doodle-doo! And I can remove that roadblock. Over here, I have another one. This says do not enter. And it is a dog. Does dog go rrr, like the car, the race car? No, it doesn't. So that's thumbs down. I can't remove that roadblock. And here I have another one. This one has a picture of a ring. I have a ring on my finger. Does ring go rrr? Why, yes it does. It goes rrr. That is an R word and I can remove that. You can take a look at some of the things I have in the back, the family, Peter's family, and the road. And now I'm gonna see if we are able to look at how we write the letter R. I'm going to get my card and write the letter R. I'm going to use red because red begins with the letter R. And I'm going to use my red marker. So I will go down, around, and kick it out. Let's see if I can try that again. I'll go down. Oops, that one kind of got a little messed up. I'm gonna go down, around, and kick it out. Now, lowercase R, you make a vertical line down, you go up and put the hook. A line goes down, come back on the same line, come back and make the hook. If you have space like that, that's not a good R. So I'm gonna cross that out. We want to make a lowercase R like this. Go down, come back on the same line, and make the hook. One more time, the line comes down, you go around, and kick it out. You can do that in the air while I do it. Help me, go down, up, and around, and there we go. That's the letter R. Well, now you know what the letter R looks like and the letter R sounds like. Let's see if we can find a rabbit that goes, well, he's not gonna go, but he's gonna have some R's and other letters on him. So let's take a look. First one I have, is this an R? Does it look like this? No, it does not. It is not the letter R. And the next one, is that a letter R, uppercase or lowercase? It is. That is a lowercase R. Is this one the letter R? No, it is not. That's the letter D. Is this one the letter R? Thumbs up if it is, thumbs down if it isn't. It is, it's an uppercase R. This one, is this the letter R? Why, yes, it is. It is the letter R. It's an uppercase R. What you could do is, if you see an R, you can run in place. That would be fun. Is that a letter R? No, it's not a letter R. Let's see, that's N. Is that a letter R? No, it's the letter Q. Is that the letter R? No, it's the letter D. Is that the letter R? It is! Run in place! Is that the letter R? No, that's an M. Is that the letter R? Yes! Run in place! Is that the letter R? Yes, it's a lowercase r. What are we gonna do? Run in place! Is that the letter R? No, that's the letter F. Well, we found pretty many letter R's, and I'm a little tired from all that running in place. But I'd like to try to show you now how you can make something that you might play with. And I'm gonna get my race car. Where did I put it? It's over here. And here's my race car. Take a look at what I have. I used two straws and I cut them, the piece of my cardboard. This is just a piece of cardboard that comes when you order things, or you might see it at the store. It's boxes are made out of it. And what you do is you make sure, it's hard for me to show you this because the marshmallows got hard, but you take a toothpick like this, and you put it in one end. Now, what I did with this one is I used some Play-Doh and I stuck it on a button, and you can do the same thing with that. And you have to wait till it gets hard, because that way it's easier to slide into the straw. The straw I taped on the back of the cardboard, and then I slid the toothpick into the straw. And that's what makes it able to roll. But I cut the marshmallow. And when I cut the marshmallow, it's just the right size for a tire. So you might want to try that at home. Now, you have to make sure that you're safe when you do this. So maybe mommy can help you. If you have any marshmallows, I cut the marshmallows in half, two pieces, and then I put them on the cardboard with tape. And then I put these on. Let's see if I can take it off and show you a little bit. There's the toothpick that I stuck into the marshmallow. And when they're soft, when you buy them at the store, they're very soft and you can do that. But then you let them out in the air a little bit and they will get hard. So there is your race car, and you can race it around the house. Make two and you can have races like that. I had to make sure that I don't drop it, but it will be so much fun for you to try that way. So those are some crafts that you might be able to do. Another one that you could do is if you get a paper plate like this and a piece of paper. And what you're gonna do on that piece of paper is you're going to trace ears. Like this, use the whole piece. And then you're going to use a scissors. And remember, when you use a scissors, you have to make sure the point is away from you. Now, this is a big scissors for grown-ups, but cut on the line like this. And when it's all cut out, you can put them on this way, and I'm using a stapler so you can see it quicker than using glue, because you have to wait for the glue to dry. And you go like this. and make some funny faces. Like this. I'm gonna put a triangle and some eyes. And there's my rabbit. So those are two crafts that you could try at home. And until next time, have fun with your race car. See you later. Bye.